Hello. The mode, or scale, is a sort of color palette that a composer uses to create music. Since the ancient time, musicians, mathematicians, philosophers thought about certain combinations of sounds and their impact on us. Even two neighboring tones can sound differently, like E, F. Sounds like the first one is unstable and resolves in the second one. Sounds like a happy end to me. And this one, not the F, G. It sounds just like a beginning. Please write in the comments if you agree with me. As a matter of fact, E, F was a semitone, the smallest distance between two tones possible. And F, G, it was the whole tone, because between these two keys there is a black one on the piano. And different combinations of those tones and semitones and the position of the main tone, finalis, can create certain emotions on us. Ancient Greek philosophers believed even that certain modes could be used to raise decent citizens, like Dorian mode. Another, like Ionian or Lydian, were more suitable for parties and feasts. Unfortunately, we have no idea how ancient Greek music sounded like. The medieval modes took over only the names of these ancient Greek modes: Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian, and Locrian. Stay tuned, and at the end of this video you'll hear how these modes coexist today with the classical major and minor. If we use only seven natural tones, we can construct seven possible medieval modes. We just have to begin with the different ground tones. Like Ionian, we begin with the C. Dorian with a D. Phrygian with the E. And so on. They are also often called the church scales, because in that time professional music was composed by and for the church. It could sound like Monty Python showed us in their movie.
Kyrie Jesu Domine, dona eis requiem. Kyrie Jesu Domine, dona eis requiem.
All these scales are based on modal relationship between the tones. We can't think of any chords to accompany a medieval melody and influence its logic, simply because the chords didn't exist at that time yet. These scales also had only one ground tone, not like in our major-minor system, where tonic sounds stable in any octaves, like here. The low tonic. High tonic. They are both stable. The ground tone finalis could be located at the beginning of the scale, like this, or in the middle, like this. And then we call it hippomodus. But for us, these scales are interesting mostly because since the end of the 19th century, they've got more and more composers' attention, and nowadays they are broadly used in pop, rock, jazz, and academic music. Ionian scale looks like a classical major scale, with the only difference: its degrees don't show their classical function. Leading tone is not seeking to resolve in tonic, neither the dominant chord. Listen how Debussy uses it in his prelude La Cathédrale engloutie. Dorian mode reminds of a minor scale because of the minor third above the ground tone, but sounds more cheerful and lightly colored because of the high sixth degree. Very famous example of Dorian mode in music is the ballad Scarborough Fair. You know it. Simon and Garfunkel did it better than me. Phrygian scale is one of the most dark colored because of the minor third on the tonic and the low second degree. Nowadays you can often find Phrygian mode in heavy metal music. Just check some pieces of Paul Gilbert. Besides, Phrygian mode is a reference mark of flamenco music, although in flamenco is mostly used the major Phrygian scale. That grew up from the flamenco cadence A, G, F, and often sounds as a variable mode floating between the two possible tonics A and E. This mode is also called dominant mode and is very common in the music of Spanish composers. Listen how it sounds in Malagueña by Albéniz. Lydian mode sounds very cheerful, festive, more lighter than a classic major scale, because of its high fourth degree. And this is how Chopin uses it in his mazurka. Mixolydian mode sounds very much like a major scale, but its lower seventh degree makes it more cloudy. And this scale is widely used in blues, like in this Basin Street Blues by Williams. Scale matches the classical minor scale, but shows less functional relationship between the scale degrees. Here is an example of Aeolian mode in Ludovico Einaudi's Le Onde. Locrian scale existed for a long time only theoretically, because it has a diminished triad on tonic, what makes it very difficult to compose in such a mode. Besides, it has a very typically dark sound and can be used only in certain compositions, like in John Kirkpatrick's Dust to Dust. So these were just few examples of how the medieval scales are used in contemporary music. There are much, much more, not to mention the whole style of jazz music organized around the modes, modal jazz. Herewith we have to understand that in contemporary music, unlike in the medieval, modal principles exist side by side with the tonal principles of classical major-minor system. We simply can't abstract away from what we know about the development of our music in the 17th and 19th centuries, from the lullabies that we've heard, or first sonatinas that we've learned. The semitone that I've mentioned at the beginning of these videos sounds as a happy end for us mostly because we used to hear it with this chord progression. Besides, the medieval scales are usually used fragmentarily, surrounded by more or less definite classical key. If you found this interesting, sign up to this channel, because there will be more about pentatonic, gypsy and symmetrical scales. Thank you for watching. Bye.